Do not miss any of our cool videos. Subscribe to our channel for latest updates. Click on the bell icon now.
Hi guys, and welcome to Robocraze. In this tutorial, we'll be learning how to interface the NFC board along with a solenoid lock to make an NFC-based door lock system. Let's jump into the hardware that is required to meet with this project. The first thing that we will need is a NFC board. For this example, I am using the Witty Fox RF430 breakout board. It is directly interfaced with this microcontroller. You can either have the NFC module plugged in using jumpers or directly interface it onto the board. The module sits on the board perfectly, and we can use our phone to tap the NFC on board. Next, we have two power supplies. This is my 5-volt power supply and this is my 12-volt power supply. Moving on to the solenoid lock, we have a DC jack breakout to which I have connected the negative terminal. With the positive terminal, I am going to go ahead and connect it into the relay. I am using the middle port of the relay. The other terminal of the relay is connected to the positive pin of the solenoid lock. From here, I have three jumpers going to my microcontroller. First, we will connect the VCC pin to 5 volts and the ground pin. Next, I will take a GPIO pin from my microcontroller and connect it as the input to the relay. You can power on the relay using the 12-volt power supply and the microcontroller using the 5-volt micro USB power supply. The relay will turn on and off every time I give a low signal to the relay. As you can see, every time I give a low signal to my relay, the solenoid lock goes in. One of the cautionary notes in this project is that the solenoid should not be activated for longer than 10 seconds. Before interfacing the entire project on a door, we need to make sure that we upload the correct firmware onto the microcontroller that we are using. We will be sharing the code with you in the blog.
So guys, here you can see that I have mounted the entire setup on a door. My RF430 board is mounted behind a window pane and is connected to my microcontroller using jumpers. The connections between my microcontroller and the relay run through a long cable along the length of the door. This has been done in order to nullify any electromagnetic interference that might be caused by the solenoid's actuations. Last but not least, I have my two power sources, my 12-volt power source and my 5-volt power source. We have also custom 3D printed a stopper for this particular application. The firmware on my microcontroller will only actuate the solenoid when the correct password is entered. Let us know in the comments below if you would like to see a separate video on the explanation of the code. For more cool project ideas, subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching and stay tuned.